Hello, this is Mac of the Studio, and I'm having Blender running on my iPad. And today I will show you the exact steps you need to know to compile and run Blender on your iPad. The Blender Foundation already published a blog about the future iOS version, and they already provided tools for developers to test Blender on their iPads. I have to say this is on a very early stage, so there might be a lot of errors, a lot of bugs, so please don't blame the developers. There will be a release version in the future, and for now everything is expected, and let's get started. If you're already an Apple developer, you can skip this part, and if you're not, let's first download Xcode. I recommend to use a tool called xcode.app. It makes download and manage Xcode easier. And for the first time, it will let you log in with your Apple ID. And if your Apple ID is not a developer ID, it will show you an annual error. It means you need to go to developer.apple.com to register your Apple ID as a developer. After that, you should be able to download Xcode normally. Please notice, don't use any beta version of Xcode, since it requires you to modify the code of Blender in order to make it compile in the beta version. After install finished, you need to make the current version of Xcode active by clicking the Make Active button. When Xcode prompts you to install the components, make sure to uncheck the AI model, since we don't need that thing. Open Xcode's preference window, click on the Components tab, and install iOS here. The next step is installing Homebrew. If you already installed Homebrew, you can skip this part. Go to brew.sh and copy the install command, run it in your terminal. Run the commands the installer provided to you, and finally, run brew to check if brew is working. Now we can use brew to install some packages. One is git-lfs and one is cmake. There are also some commands we need to run after the install. In this case, it's git-lfs install. Since Homebrew updated Xcode command line tools, we need to select the version of command line tools again in Xcode's preference window. Now we can finally start to build Blender. Go and clone the official GitHub repository. Please don't use the GitHub mirror, since it lacks some files we need from LFS. Now go to the Blender folder and check out iOS branch. Now refresh the LFS again to make sure all the files are downloaded. Download all the libraries for the iOS version and the Mac version. Now we need to go to the parent folder and use this command to generate the iOS project. Now we can finally open the iOS Xcode project. When Xcode prompts you about the schemas, click manually. Add a new schema, select the target install. Select the schema, click edit, and set executable to Blender. Open Xcode's preference again, select Tab Account, and log in with your Apple ID. Select Project in the Navigator, and find the target Blender Cross Tools Compile. Select the Build Phrases, and expand to Generate cmake files step. Copy the text under the debug section from env-i to make tools. Paste all the text to a text editor. Now we need to add paths to environment variables. The original instruction says we should edit the script inside Xcode, but I found it's easier to run the script outside of Xcode, since we can see the errors immediately. Now cd to the Blender folder and run this along command. Check for install builds only inside Xcode to prevent this script to run in the future. Now find the Blender target and select your Apple ID. Set the bundle identifier to something other. Maybe add your name after the Blender foundation. This identifier should be unique, so if there is any error, just change it again. Also, set your Apple ID for ZSTD compress target, but this time leave the identifier blank. Now connect and select your device. In this list, we can finally start to build Blender. Change to the Report tab in the Navigator, select Latest Build, and click All and All Messages. Bring yourself a cup of coffee or tea, then sit down and enjoy the scrolling build logs. Now let's turn to the iPad. As you can see, the system prompts us this account is not allowed to run app on the iPad. Go to Settings, VPN Device Management, trust your Apple ID. Now we can finally run Blender on our iPad. Please notice on iOS 26 beta, even though Blender can show the UI, you can't interact with the app, so please use iOS 18 or before. As a final tip, if you want to bundle any files to test, please add a copy file phrase in the Blender target. Set the destination to executables, add your blend file, and turn on cosign. Only standalone files will work in the current version. And that's it. I leave all the commands and reference links in the description. This channel is for apps I made, artworks I made, and tutorials of creation tools. If you want to see more video, please like and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, please leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.